I remember in March when the pandemic first started.
Medical facilities have spent weeks scrambling to get what they need.
The lack of hospital beds and ventilators available.
Are there enough ventilators in this country?
And it was like looking at a bonfire and just staring at the flame. So the decision was, do I run into the barn, not knowing what I was doing, and try to help out, or was I to turn and run?
At the beginning of COVID, there was a huge ventilator shortage.
There was this big insecurity, especially among rural hospitals, because they knew that it would be too much to handle. One thing was very, very clear. We couldn't sit and wait around.
A team of our colleagues came together at UT Austin to build this automated bag breathing unit.
For something less than $2,000, you could have a bridge device that could help you not ration care and not sit and try and figure out which patient should be prioritized for the ventilator. Because these ventilator devices, they are typically extremely expensive and extremely complex.
The challenges in building a device like this is integrating a lot of ideas from engineers, medical professions, scientists, business people, and taking an idea that we need to provide a low-cost ventilator and do it quickly.
Before the product even started getting built, we made sure that we brought in clinicians to provide input on what the device should look like to be clinically relevant, because there would be no point building a bridge ventilator if clinicians didn't want to ever use it. Dell Med is a very, very community-focused organization, and any chance to help the community fill a crucial gap was definitely high priority for Dell Med. So as soon as we saw this project, we jumped right in.
This is not something that universities do. Our team had to learn very fast in terms of how to develop a finished product within a matter of weeks.
The engineers decided to build software into their project so that there would be a feature called patient assist, which means that when the patient is trying to breathe on their own, the device isn't fighting them. It's helping them take that next breath.
We are awaiting FDA approval to launch the ABU nationally and internationally. Because of the low costs of the ABU to produce, this device will allow many lives to be saved.
This has the potential to change the world and make a true impact for rural communities across the globe.
It will be rewarding when we hear the stories of it saving lives.